Hello everyone, welcome to the second lecture on assignment problem. In the first lecture, we discussed what is an assignment problem and we solved one simple assignment problem. To recall the things that we have studied in the previous lecture, we defined assignment problem as the problem wherein we would like to minimize the cost of allocating a job to people or the machine, subject to the constraint that each person will get only one job and each job will go to only one person, which means each row will have only one assignment and each column will have only one assignment. And in the assignment problem, the total number of jobs will be equal to the total number of people. That is, we will have a square matrix with the equal number of rows and columns. The solution to the assignment problem is given by Hungarian method, which will give the optimal solution to the assignment problem. In today's lecture, we shall see how to solve the various assignment problem. Consider this particular example. The cost matrix is given here. There are four jobs which have to be done by four people. So it is a 4x4 assignment problem. There are four number of rows and four number of column. So whenever the assignment problem is given, just see that the cost matrix that is given is having the equal number of rows and the columns. That is, we must have a square matrix in order to apply the Hungarian method to get the optimal solution to the assignment problem. Now, let us see how to solve this problem using Hungarian method. Firstly, we would like to reduce the given cost matrix to the matrix which will have a zero cost, so that we can make an assignment to the zero cost. So we perform row reduction to the given cost matrix. Under row reduction, we identify the minimum element in each row and subtract it from all the other element of that row. Now, when we perform the row reduction, okay, on this given cost matrix, consider the first row. The first row is having the minimum element 4. Subtract this 4 from all the element of the first row. We get 8 minus 4, 4, 6 minus 4, 2, 4 minus 4, 0, and 9 minus 4, 5. Next, consider the second row. Here the minimum element is 5. Subtract 5 from all the element of the second row. We get 7 minus 5, 2, 5 minus 5, 0, 6 minus 5, 1, 9 minus 5, 4. Now consider the third row. The third row has 9 as a minimum element. Subtract 9 from all the element of the third row. We get 9 minus 9, 0, 10 minus 9, 1, 11 minus 9, 2, 12 minus 9, 3. And in the fourth row, 6 is a minimum element. Subtract this 6 from all the element of the fourth row. We get 9 minus 6, 3. 6 minus 6, 0, 8 minus 6, 2, 11 minus 6, 5. So this is the first reduced matrix we get after applying a row reduction. Next, whatever we did on the row will also applicable on the column as well. So in the second step, we perform column reduction . That is, subtract the column minimum from all the column values. Now, here in the first column 0 is a minimum element. Subtracting all the element of the first column from 0 we get 4, 2, 0, 3. Similarly in the second column we have the minimum element 0. Subtracting it from all the element of the second column we get 2, 0, 1, 0. In the third column, 0 is a minimum element. Subtract all the element of third column from 0. So we get 0, 1, 2, 2. Here, 3 is a minimum element. Subtract 3 from all the element of the fourth column. So we get 5 minus 3, 2, 4 minus 3, 1, 3 minus 3, 0, 5 minus 3, 2. So this is a second reduced matrix. After this, we perform zero assignment. Now look at this second reduced matrix. The way how we perform zero assignment is as follows. Examine each row successively until exactly a single zero is found. If so, assign that zero. Okay, make an assignment to that zero, and if there is any zero present in that particular column, just put a cross over to that. Okay, so now we'll consider the first row. Okay, in the first row we have exactly a single zero is found. Okay, so I have copied the second reduced matrix and will perform the zero assignment. Okay, so in the first row exactly a single zero is found, so we assign this particular zero, and this is marked using this box. Okay, which means that the first job is assigned to the third person. Now you just see whether there is any zero present in this particular column. There is no zero present. Next, take up the second row. Now here also in the second row we have exactly single zero is found, so we make an assignment using box, and you just check that particular column, is there any other zero found. Okay, so here we have a zero, so we just put a cross over to the zero. Why we do this is already a second job already a second person is given with the second person is given with the second job, so he cannot be assigned to any other job. That is, each person gets only one job. That is the constraint given in the assignment problem. So we put a cross over to this zero. Next, consider the third row. In the third row we have two zeros, so we do not make an assignment, just leave that row. And in the fourth row we do not have a zero, so just leave it. Now next we perform zero assignment with respect to the column. Now take up the first column. So here the first column has exactly a single zero is found, so make an assignment, and if there is any other zero found in this particular row, okay, put a cross over to that. So here we have a zero present in the third row, so we put a cross over that, saying that the third job is assigned to the first person, so this third job cannot be given to the fourth person. So we put a cross over here. Next, consider the second column. So in the second column already there is an assignment, so we move to the third column. Here also already there is an assignment. Now we take up the fourth column, so here there is no zero found. Now if you consider the first assignment problem that we have solved. Okay, now there after once we performed the zero assignment, we found that all the jobs has been assigned to any one of the person. So we got the feasible solution while performing the zero assignment. But here you can see there is a we have a situation wherein okay we could make up only three assignments. The fourth job is not assigned to any person, so this is not the feasible solution. That is, it is not satisfying the constraint that each job must go to only one person and each person gets only one job. Okay, so we have to do something different now here. Okay, so we somehow try to reduce this matrix, okay, by the method called as ticking and line drawing. Ticking and line drawing. Now let us see how this method is used, okay, to get the next reduced matrix to make the assignment. Now ticking is done as follows. Tick an unassigned row. Okay, so if you consider the four rows here, okay, the fourth row is unassigned, so tick this particular row. And next step is, okay, if there is any zero found, okay, in the ticked row, okay, tick that particular column. Okay, now in the ticked column, if there is any assignment, okay, tick this particular row. And repeat this step, okay, repeat these ticking steps until no more ticks are possible. Okay, again to repeat. Okay, ticking is done in this way. Okay, tick an unassigned row. Here first row is already assigned, this is assigned, this one is assigned, so fourth row is unassigned, so tick an unassigned row. And if there is a zero present in the ticked row, tick that particular column. Now if you consider this row, there is a zero present here, so we tick this column. And now if the ticked column has a zero, has an assignment in it, then tick that particular row. Now if you consider this ticked column, there is an assignment, so this row will be ticked. Now again you have to see whether this tick has any zero here. No zero, so we stop the ticking process. The next thing is, okay, we do something called as line drawing. That is, we will draw a line for the unticked rows. So this is an unticked rows. Okay, now this is also an unticked rows. So draw a line on the unticked rows and the ticked column. Ticked column. Okay. Now what is the objective of doing this ticking and the line drawing? Okay, its objective is to cover all the zeros that is present in the cost matrix with a minimum number of lines. Now here we covered all the zeros of the cost matrix with, okay, three number of lines. Okay, once the lines are drawn, you have to see whether the total number of lines that is drawn to cover all the zeros is equal to the order of the matrix. Now here the total number of lines drawn are 3. Okay, we have to see whether it is equal to the order of matrix. The order of matrix is 4 here. It is not equal. Okay, so if it is not equal, then we cannot make an optimal, we cannot get the optimal solution in the next step. Okay, so if the total number of lines drawn is equal to the order of matrix, okay, that is lines drawn is equal to order of matrix, then we can make a optimal assignment. Okay, then we can make an optimal assignment. Okay, otherwise, okay, once you are done with the ticking and the line drawing process, okay, if the total number of lines drawn is not equal to the order of matrix, then we have to reduce the matrix in this way. That is, we have to identify which is the minimum element in the uncovered numbers. For example, here 211322 are the uncovered numbers. Okay, so the minimum out of it is 1. So here we take this minimum element as theta. So here theta is equal to 1. Now we have to subtract theta from all the uncovered numbers. Okay, that is subtract theta from all uncovered numbers and add theta to the number where lines are intersecting. Intersecting and untouch covered by one line. Okay, so if the total number of lines drawn is not equal to the order of matrix, we will find out the next reduced matrix. Okay, this way, that is, we find theta. Theta is nothing but the minimum element. Theta is the minimum element of uncovered numbers. Okay, so here 211322 are the numbers which are not covered by any lines. So the minimum here is 1. So we have to subtract this 1 from all the uncovered number, add 1 to the number where there is two lines are intersecting, and untouch the numbers that is covered by one line. So we get the next reduced matrix as, okay, so here 4 is covered by one line, so keep it as it is. 4 2, okay, there are two lines are intersecting, so add theta to it. So 2 plus 1 becomes 3, and here 0 covered by one line, so keep it as it is. 2 covered by one line, keep it as it is. Now here 2 is an uncovered number, so subtract theta from 2, that is 2 minus 1 becomes 1. Okay, so this the second, that is 0. Okay, so here 0 is covered by one line, so keep it as it is. So 1 is an uncovered number, so subtract theta from it. So 1 minus 1 0, 1 minus 1 0. So here 0, keep it as it is. 1, okay, okay, here two lines are intersecting, so add theta to it, so it becomes 2, and this is covered by one line, so 2, and keep 0 as it is. So this is the last row. If you consider, 3 is an uncovered number. Okay, so 3 minus 1 2. Okay, so 0, keep it as it is. 2 minus 1 1, 2 minus 1 1. So this is the next reduced matrix that we get. Now you perform zero assignment. Okay, that is, consider the first row. Okay, this row has exactly a single zero, so make an assignment. Okay, if there is any other zero found in the same column, then put a cross over to that. Now consider the second row. It has two zeros, so just leave this row. Next, third row also has two zeros, so just leave it. Okay, fourth row has a single zero, so make an assignment here. Now if there is any zero with respect to this column, then put a cross over to that. Okay, So now we are done with row. Now we have to examine each column individually. Okay, now in the first column we have a single zero found, so make an assignment. If there is any zero found here, then put a cross over to that. Okay, next, in the second column already an assignment is made, in the third column already an assignment is made, and in the fourth column, okay, a single zero is found, so make an assignment. So now if you look at the total number of assignments made, okay, so there are four assignments made, which is equal to the order of the matrix, as well as it is satisfying the constraint that each person gets only one job. Okay, so that is row wise only one assignment is found, column wise also only one assignment is found. So this is the feasible solution as well as the optimal one. Okay, so we write the optimal solution as, optimal solution is, okay, x, so this is first job j1, j2, j3, j4, this is p1, person 1, person 2, person 3, person 4. So job 1 is assigned to the third person, job 2 is assigned to fourth person, and job 3 is assigned to first person, and job 4 is assigned to second person. So we define all this decision variable value as 1. That is, first job is assigned to third person, so we write its value 1. Second job is assigned to fourth person, third job is assigned to first person, fourth job is assigned to the second person, so that is equal to 1. So this is the optimal and the feasible solution. Now the total cost of allocation is x13. Just look at the given matrix. Okay, so x13, okay, the cost of allocating the first job, the cost of allocating the first job to the third person, it cost 4 plus the cost of allocating the second job to the fourth person, it cost 9 rupees. The cost of allocating third job to the first person, it cost 9 rupees. Plus cost of allocating fourth job to the second person, it cost 6 rupees. So the total cost is 28. Now, in this particular problem, we could not make the feasible assignment or the optimal assignment in the very beginning, performing a zero assignment. Okay, we found that we had less number of assignment than the order of matrix. Okay, with all the zeros either boxed or crossed over, so we went to do something different called as sticking and the line drawing method. Okay, so we'll just recall that again. Okay, so this is the way we did the ticking procedure, that is, tick the unassigned rows. Okay, if a ticked row has a zero, tick the corresponding column. If a ticked column has an assignment, tick the corresponding row. Okay, we have to repeat step 2 and 3 till no more ticks are possible. Now draw the line through unticked rows and ticked column. If the total number of lines drawn is not equal to the order of matrix, then again we have to reduce the matrix in this way. That is, we have to find theta from all the uncovered numbers, add theta to the numbers having two lines passing through them. Numbers with one line passing through them will remain the same. To this reduced matrix, we'll again perform the zero assignment. If the feasible assignment cannot be done, then again we have to perform the ticking and the line drawing procedure. If the total number of line drawn is equal to the order of the matrix, then optimal assignment can be made. Let us solve the next problem. The problem given is find the optimal assignment. Okay, so the row represent the four jobs and the column represent four people. So we have to make an assignment so that each job is assigned to only one person and each person gets only one job. So the first and foremost thing is we have to see whether the given cost matrix is a square matrix, A series. So it is a 4x4 assignment problem. Okay, so we can apply the Hungarian method to find the optimal solution. So firstly, we perform row reduction. Okay. That is, identify the minimum element in each row and subtracting it from all other elements of that row. Okay. So, in the first row we have minimum element 4, subtract 4 from all other element of the first row, so we get 8 minus 4 4 6 minus 4 2 4 minus 4 0 7 minus 4 is 3. Okay, so in the second row we have the 5 is a minimum element. Okay, so subtract 5 from all other element of the second row, so we get 6 minus 5 1, 5 minus 5 0, this is 0, so 8 minus 5 3. And in the third row the minimum element is 9, subtract 9 from all other elements, so we get 9 minus 9 0, 10 minus 9 1, 11 minus 9 is 2, 12 minus 9 is 3. Okay, so in the fourth row we have the minimum element 6, so subtract 6 from all these element of the fourth row, so we get 7 minus 6 1, 6 minus 6 0, 8 minus 6 2, 10 minus 6 is 4. Now next we perform column reduction, that is subtracting column minimum from each column, we get in the first column the minimum element is 0, subtract 0 from all the element of the first column, so we get 4 1 0 1. Here again the minimum element is 0 in the second column, so we get 2 0 1 0. Now here in the third column we get minimum element is 0, so subtracting 0 from all the other element of the third column we get 0 0 2 2. And in the last column the minimum element is 3, here subtracting 3 from all other element of the fourth column we get 3 minus 3 0, 3 minus 3 0, 3 minus 3 0, 4 minus 3 1. Next we perform zero assignment, we perform zero assignment. Rewrite the second reduced matrix 4 to this matrix we are writing here 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 2 0 1 0 2 1. So we will check each rows for single zero, if so make an assignment there. So if you consider the first row it has 2 zeros, so we do not make an assignment. Second row has 3 zeros, so we do not make an assignment. Third row has 2 zeros, so we do not make an assignment. Fourth row has a single zero, so we make an assignment and put a cross over to the any other zero if found in the same in that particular column. So here we made an assignment here. Okay, so there is a zero present here in this column, so we put a cross over to that. Okay, next we are done with all the rows. Now we will take up each column. Okay, so if you consider the first column, so there is a single zero found. Okay, so we will assign this row using box. Okay, and if any other zero found in this particular row, then we put a cross over to that. Okay, so put a cross over to that. Now take up the second column, already an assignment is made. Take up the third column, so here 2 zeros, so don't make an assignment. Here also there is 2 zeros in the fourth column, so do not we don't make an assignment. Now Here there is a situation where all the zeros are not boxed or crossed over. Some of the zeros are still hanging, and therefore we cannot start our ticking and the line drawing procedure. Okay, you can see here these four rows, they are still hanging. Okay, they are not even boxed or crossed over, so we cannot start our ticking and the line drawing procedure. Okay, this can be resolved by making an arbitrary assignment. Okay, so now arbitrarily make an assignment here. Now if you consider, take up the first row, so here there is two zeros, so arbitrarily we will assign this zero. So this we will put a cross over to this zero as well as to this zero, because here the third person gets the first job, so he cannot get any other job. Okay, so we are done with assigning the third assignment. Next, if you consider the next column, here there is a single zero found, so make an assignment here. Okay, so now the total number of assignment is equal to the order of matrix, satisfying the constraint that each row has exactly one assignment and each column has exactly one assignment. So this is one solution. You can make one more assignment. For example, if I assign this zero, then this will be crossed over, this will be crossed over. Now the third column has left with one zero, so we make an assignment. So this is one more possible solution for the given problem. Okay, that means this particular problem has multi-optimal solution, so that is it has alternate optimum. Okay, one solution is x, the first job is assigned to the third person, x13 is equal to the second job is assigned to the fourth person, x24 is equal to the third job is assigned to the first person, x31 is equal to the fourth job is assigned to the third person, x42 is equal to 1. So this is one solution, and one more solution is this one. That is, the first job is assigned to fourth person, the second job is assigned to third person, the third job third job is assigned to the first person, and the fourth job is assigned to the second person, x42 is equal to 1. Now the cost of the first solution is x13 is equal to, so if you take up the cost matrix, x13 is equal to 4 plus x24 is equal to 8 plus x31 is equal to 9 plus x42 is equal to 6, which is equal to 27. Now the second solution cost is x14 is equal to 7 plus x23 is equal to 5 plus x31 is equal to 9 plus x42 is equal to 6. That also will give the same solution, 27. So this particular problem has alternate optimum. Okay, so that there is two solution which gives the minimum value 27. So the things that we studied from the third type of problem is, okay, after making the zero assignment, if you find that there are still some zeros are hanging which are not even boxed or crossed over, then we make a arbitrary assignment. So such a problem will have alternate optimum.